The euro currency finished the session today strong, posting a one-week high. And recall, it was about a week and a half ago that we saw it trade south of its 50-day moving average, all the way down to 116, and today it got back up to 118, not quite back to its 50-day moving average, but nearing that level, and that would be kind of a technical relief given the fact that we broke through the moving day average and kind of went straight down. Yes, it did turn positive, but that was more so because we saw the dollar turn negative at about the same time. So really an inverse relationship there that we've seen take place. Not a whole lot that would be supporting the euro other than the weaker dollar at this point, and certainly with all the uncertainty ahead for the European Union, that would make sense. The ECB itself right now is trying to figure out what it's going to do. It's seeing weaker inflation data, it's seeing weaker jobs numbers, and it's seeing weaker PMIs, all which would lend to them having to maybe step up some of their efforts, their central banking efforts, maybe buying more assets, maybe taking rates more negative. It's right now up in the air as to what they will do, but ultimately they're going to have to do something given the fact that the data just doesn't seem very pleasing. Although with the euro rising here, they probably have a little time on their side. Euro hasn't been plummeting. That's probably a positive thing at this point, given the fact that the central bank wants to wait and see and kind of get through some of the pandemic, get through some of these, see if the economy can get itself back on its sea legs. And right now that just isn't happening, and we're seeing that in the numbers. Lastly, the Brexit. What about Brexit? Boy, it seems like it's been 2 years since we heard about Brexit start back in 2016. But ultimately, their backs are against the wall. And today we had the EU gave notice to the UK about their breaching of an agreement. And right now, that's going to kind of take center stage. It's going to take away from their talks. It's going to take away from the trade talks that they've had. And they've got trade deadlines coming up. Certainly that is being reflected in the pound, which is weaker today against the euro. And that is actually seeing a little bit of an ascension when the talks were going well. The British pound was doing better against the euro, but that has all since slowed. So we're now starting to see the euro outperform the pound. That's an indication, I think, that there could be a no Brexit deal out there. Still a lot of uncertainty and still a little bit of time left for them to get their act together. But certainly the clock is ticking. So the euro currency right now, seeing a bit of a bid almost to end the week. It'll be interesting to see if you can hang on to this bid, given the uncertainty and given the weak economic data, and of course, given what happens with Brexit.